just imagine that these are employees that we have and their salary and everything. Now we want to create a new sheet. And in this sheet, let's rename it to sales. We mention how much each employee has sold amounts. So sale, employee ID and sold. Okay. Now we go to salary file and let's say we choose a bunch of these employees, maybe the first five, copy that to the sales table. And let's choose from 10 to 15 as well. I'm just choosing a bunch of employees to have them in our sales folder, okay? And just erase the sold. We want the employee ID and how much these people have sold. So employee ID has sold $10,000. Next employee has sold $20,000. Next one, $5,000, $15,000. This is how much each one of these employees have sold. Okay, and now let's say the same employees in another day, they sell another set of amounts, okay? So this is the second, I changed the color. Basically the same set of employees are now selling another amount. We have two sets of sales by these employees. But the problem is that, let's say if you want to know what is the total sale of each employee, you know what to do. I want to show you. If I want to see the total sales of each one of these employees, I would insert a pivot table, and I can easily see that this employee sold in total this much. Good. So is this a good result? This is not really a good result. The problem is that we don't know actually who is this guy, 10936, who has sold this amount. There is a problem here that we, you know, we want to actually see the name of the person, but we are just seeing the numbers. So this pivot table that I created is not really good. I'm going to delete it. So from this data, I want to create a pivot table that shows me the name of the employee and the amount that that person has sold, okay? So to do that, now this part, you have to follow me. Click on this salary tab and select this whole data. Select this table and then we want to create a table from this data. So we click on insert and then we click on table. And yes, we selected the headers. Okay. So now we created a table. Okay. And remember that this is table one. We can give it a name. So let's call it all data. So on the second tab, we select these two columns. And again, we create a table. And this one, we call it sales table. So notice that the goal is to link these two tables such that we can find the name of each one of these employees. Now we go to data and we click on relationships. And we click on new. Now for the primary table, the primary table is where everything is defined, which is our table one. Okay. And the primary column is the ID of the employee. The ID of the employee, right? Was it the ID of the employee? And then in the the top table, we choose sales, and we choose employee ID. So now that we created the relationship, something interesting happens, okay? So I create a pivot table again, insert pivot table, and this time I say add this data to the data model. The only thing that I do differently after creation of the two tables and relationship is clicking on this checkbox, and I click OK. Now, in here, we click on all, and from the sales, I choose the sold amount goes to the sum, and instead of showing the ID, I show the first name of the employee. It's actually multi-sheet pivot. Multi-sheet pivot. So part of the data is coming from the sheet that has the first name. Part of the data is coming from the sold column of the sales sheet. So this pivot that we are observing here has the data from two different sheets.